Welcome to Learning at UK Healthcare. This video will briefly demonstrate some of the commonly used functions in HQPM. HealthQuest Patient Management, or HQPM, is a database of patient and appointment information used by UK Healthcare. Depending upon how your computer connects to the mainframe, you will see one of two initial screens when you double-click on the Host Explorer UK HOSP icon. These two screens are known as VTAM and NetView Access, otherwise called the Big UK screen. Most areas receive the VTAM screen. We'll start there. Begin by double-clicking on the Host Explorer UK HOSP icon. The VTAM application menu offers a list of keywords to allow access to different systems on the mainframe. Prod, or production, is where HQPM resides. Type prod and press enter. Check the bulletin board screen for any announcements and press the pause break key to clear the screen. On the blank screen, type CESN and press enter. Type your user ID and press the tab key. Type your password and then press enter. On the blank screen, type MPAC for the medical package and press enter. Finally, type an X in front of PTMG and press enter. The functions available to you depend upon your role. To log off, press the pause break key until you reach a blank screen. Type CESF, space, log off, and press enter. Remember, any system you use a password to log on, you must log off properly. Now we will log on through the NetView Access screen, also called the Big UK screen. This is a two-step process. First, you must log on to the mainframe, and then onto CICS. Begin by double-clicking on the Host Explorer UK HOSP icon. Type your user ID and press the tab key. Type your password and then press the tab key enough times to reach the group field. Type public and press enter. Type 1 on the command line and press enter. Press pause break to clear the bulletin board. On the blank screen, type CESN and press enter. Type your user ID and press the tab key. Then type your password and press enter. On the blank screen, type MPAC to access the medical package and press enter. Finally, type an X in front of PTMG and press enter. The functions available to you depend upon your role. Logging off through NetView Access is also a two-stage process. To log off, press the pause break key until you reach a blank screen. Type CESF, space, log off, and press enter. Type log off on the command line and press enter. When you are back at the UK screen, click on the X and then click OK to close the session. Remember, any system you use a password to log on, you must log off properly. In this case, there were two logins, this two log offs. Maneuvering through HQPM is best done using the keyboard and not the mouse. The cursor must be in the exact right and visible spot in order for things to work. The tab key will move the cursor forward from one field to the next, while the shift plus tab combination moves it backward through the fields. The enter key will move you from one screen to the next. If a screen has more than one page, F8 will page forward, while F7 pages backward. To move back to the previous screen, use F3. The home key jumps the cursor to the last name field on search screens. When you press the pause break key, HQPM will cancel whatever function you are in and return you to the function selection screen. There are three ways to start functions within HQPM. First, on the function selection screen, use the tab key to move the cursor to the field in front of the function name, type an X, and then press enter. Secondly, you may use your mouse to right-click on the function name. The third and most widely used, because it can be done on any screen and the cursor is usually already in place, is to type over the abbreviation in the function field in the lower right-hand corner and then press enter. Info, the information desk inquiry function, is used in response to an outside request for a patient's room or phone number. Never use SCM or any other clinical system to answer such an inquiry. Patients whose privacy must be kept, such as prisoners or victims of abuse, will not be found in info, therefore privacy is ensured. Look up a patient's location by typing their last name, followed by a comma and a space, then the first name, and press enter. The patient listing screen displays an alphabetical list of patients beginning with the name entered. After the patient's name is the pavilion, followed by the unit, the room number, and bed number. The type column indicates the type of patient. The listed phone number is in the patient's room. The age column may help to identify the correct patient. The admit column shows the date of admission or visit to a clinic, and the discharge column indicates when the patient left our facility. Any patients here for less than 24 hours will remain on this list for 3 days after departure. Inpatients remain on this list for a total of 10 days. If there is an indicator in the expired column and a date in the discharge column, that means the patient died while here. Any inquiries regarding a patient so indicated should be directed to the family. Do not inform the caller that the person has died. Simply relate that they are no longer in our hospital. The visitors and condition columns are not used. When finished with the info function, press the pause break key once to return to the function selection menu. Patient demographics are retrieved with the CPII function. You may search by social security number, name, or medical record number. Let's use the medical record number. In this example, notice the S highlighted at the top and the white banner across the bottom of the screen. This indicates the patient's information has been suppressed. Therefore, he would not show up in an info search. On this screen, you will find medical record number, name, birth date, social security number, address, and phone numbers right up top. Other useful items, such as primary language and meaningful use information, are also found on this screen. The person information to screen has a temporary address field in case the patient has another residence elsewhere. There is an email address field here, as well as the patient's PCP's staff ID number, name, and phone number. Employment information, including status, place of work, job title, and work phone, is listed here, and there are 3 comment lines also. To look up demographic information for another patient, press F3 twice to return to the CPII search screen. Let's do another medical record number search. Occasionally, you may have an MRN that the system cannot find. If that is the case, use the CPIX function. CPIX searches for combined medical record accounts. Type the rejected number and press Enter. A number of patients, for one reason or another, have had multiple medical record numbers assigned to them. When this is discovered, the most recent MRN is discarded and all records are merged under the original medical record number. When done, press Pause Break. PATI will allow you to review the registration information for the past 18 months or so of appointments. The Home key jumps the cursor to the last name field for a name search. Type the last name and press Tab. Type the first name and press Enter. Type the appropriate line number and press Enter. The Visit History Selection screen shows past appointments with the most recent visit first. The visit suffix is a unique identifier for that day's registration and is tied to the registration date. The financial class can be seen here as well as the visit date, type, location, service, and attending physician. Tab to a particular option to view only that information. We will view all these screens. The guarantor is the person paying for the visit. Here we see the guarantor's relationship to the patient, ID number, and identifying information. Press Enter to move to the next screen. There is a secondary address field on the guarantor's employer's screen, as well as 2 employment information areas. Contact and employment information for up to 2 additional insured people is on the insured information screens. For this visit, the insured person is the patient as well as the guarantor. The nearest relative's contact information and relationship to the patient are displayed here. Employment information may also be recorded. If the patient is newborn, parental information is displayed at the bottom of the screen. The name and 2 phone numbers for the emergency contact, as well as their relationship to the patient, are displayed at the top of this screen. If the visit was due to an accident, the details about the accident will be displayed here as well. The insurance plans attached to this visit are indicated with X's, and the COB is listed on the right. There is also an area for notes here. Press Enter to view the details of the selected plans. The name, as it appears on the policy, as well as plan details, including group name, numbers, and dates, are listed. Contact information for the company is also here. Press Enter to return to the insurance company selection screen. Press F9 to move on. Admitting, attending PCP, and referring physician identification is grouped here along with the reason for the visit. The date and check-in time are posted on the visit-specific outpatient screen. Other information listed here includes the visit type, source, patient class, service, location, registration date, and whether the consent forms were signed. The date, time, location, and discharge disposition are displayed on the discharge information screen. Medical information is not stored in this system. Billing codes and occurrence information are displayed on the UB's codes screen. Press F3 to return to the visit history selection screen. Notice the visit number column shows more than one visit on this date. To see where the other visit was, use VISI. VISI is the visit history inquiry. Press F9 to stay on the same account. A summary of certain registration information for the appointment just viewed is displayed. Press F3. Type the appropriate line number and press Enter to see the visit history information screen for that date. Press F3 to back up and press F11 to see the multiple appointments. All the patient's visits for that date are displayed. Press pause break when finished with VISI. To see every department in which a patient has had an appointment, use the chart location inquiry function, SCNI. HQPM utilizes a Soundex process when performing name searches. The system will return whatever sounds like the name entered. This allows for alternate spellings of names. There may be multiple patients with the same name. Use the information on this screen to select the proper patient. In this case, all three listings are the same person. The AKA indicator shows which are aliases. Line number 3 shows the patient's legal name. Select that one. The patient's identifying information is displayed at the top of the screen, and chart location information is listed below. Department and date of last activity are followed by whether the patient is considered active or inactive, the year the status was assigned, and where the inactive charts are stored. PROI, the Professional Master Inquiry, shows information about our UK healthcare professionals. You may search by name or staff ID number. There is a filter for either physicians or all healthcare professionals. The physician type indicates where the physician has privileges. This will be displayed on the information screen. Search by last name. Select the provider from the list and press Enter. The physician's credentials, specialties, and contact information are shown on screen 1. An additional office may be seen by pressing F9. UK healthcare statuses and outside identification numbers are listed on screen 2. Press pause break when finished viewing the information on this screen. When using any of the census functions, you must ensure that the system is searching the correct pavilion. To change the pavilion, type over the abbreviation and press Enter, then start the function. CENI is a powerful search engine. Type a location and press Enter to see a list of all the patients there. F8 will page you forward and F7 backward. Pressing F12 on the search screen will send the list to the printer. Press F3 and delete your search criteria. Another search could be for all the patients that a doctor is the attending for. Type the last name, select the type, and press Enter. Type the line number and press Enter. Press Enter. Press pause break when done. PPRF is used to print face sheets for patient visits.
You may do a name search or search by visit number, social security number, or medical record number. Select the patient from the list and type the line number corresponding to the appropriate visit. Change the number of copies to print or simply press Enter.
This video has been brought to you by Enterprise Learning at UK Healthcare. For more information, contact the Learning Center at 257-9226 or send an email to tlc@uky.edu.